Hi y'all. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create the sci-fi invisibility material in Blender. It's important to mention that this material will only work in Blender's cycle render engine. If you'd like to skip this tutorial, there's a link to my Gumroad page in the video description below. I'm in Blender 3.0 and I've switched over to cycles. Also, for the sake of demonstration, so the invisibility shader has something to reflect, I have added some simple shapes and a plane with an image texture on it in the background, as well as two area lights set to 300. First, you're going to want to add the object you want to apply the invisibility shader to. While this material works with either flat or smooth objects, I think the effect looks more convincing with a smooth surface, so I've applied a subdivision modifier and set the shader mode to smooth. With your object selected, switch to the shader menu and delete the default material node. The reveal effect is primarily created using the refraction shader and the transparent shader. They look similar, but a transparent shader is completely invisible, while a refraction shader behaves more like glass. So add a refraction shader, a transparent shader, and a mix shader. Connect the refraction shader to the bottom of the mix shader and the transparent shader to the top of the mix shader, and the output of the mix shader to the material output. Right now, the mix shader is splitting the transparent shader and the refraction shader evenly across the surface of the monkey, which is making the form of the monkey a little difficult to see. We're going to clean that up using the light path node to let the mix shader know that we only want the surface facing us use the refraction shader, and have the surface that's not facing us use the transparent shader. Now that we have the general look of the invisibility material, we want to be able to switch the monkey from being completely invisible to what we see here. To do that, we're going to want to add another mix shader and another transparent shader. Now that you have all of the nodes set up for this material, we're going to want to animate the different nodes to create the transition effect. For the mix shader, we're going to want to keyframe it at 1 at frame 10, so the monkey is completely invisible, and 0 at frame 15, so the monkey can appear. Right now the transition looks a little bland, so we're going to animate the IOR factor on the refraction node. This will give the transition a little bit more of a supernatural appearance by distorting the light, because the IOR is the angle at which the refraction shader bends the light passing through it. This will give it a little bit more of a sci-fi-y look. I've set an IOR keyframe at 1 at frame 10 and a keyframe at 1.12 at frame 95. You don't have to match these numbers specifically, this is just what I thought looked cool. You set the IOR higher or lower, however you like. Right now, if you look closely at the top of your object, you can see some gray, and that's because we're reflecting some of the light from the sky, which is because we haven't adjusted it, so it's the default gray, which looks kind of gross. So in the shader menu, I'm going to switch from object to world and add an environment texture. And there you go. Now you have a sci-fi visibility material. Hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.